Hello, guys. He's going for his ball. Typical. Let's go see the other one. Buddy! Buddy! Like grabbing our ear. Oh, mosquito. Ah, let's go inside. And I'm here in my workshop with a good company. Don't know how long he's going to stay calm. Ah, that's a good sign. Now, as you can see, I have painted the dead eyes black. I have the ropes that I need for we're going to begin the rope ladders. I'm going to use 1 millimeter dark brown, as you can see here, for the rope ladders. 0.4 here and 0.35 also for the rope ladders, and for the dead eyes 0.45 this one. I have everything that I need over here. Now this is a very boring procedure for me, one that I must do, but very boring. Now, let me get the camera on tripod and I'll get back to you. Alright. Now, we have 11 dead eyes on the main mast, 11 on the front mast, 6 on the rear. You see that I have this one, this is going to be single. The idea is exactly the same, but the single is going to be one line, not two. Now, we're going to make them in pairs. First, we're going to make these two pairs. I'm going to place these pieces on. The small ones will be done after I finish with the rope ladders. A lot time after, much time. Let me show you a couple of things. I have placed the mast. From this point of view you cannot see, but you can tell this one has a small angle over to this side. That means that I have to pull it over to this side, like that, you can see, and it's going to be perfect. That will be done with these small dead eyes over here, and I believe with these small dead eyes over here, either these are for the main mast, with these dead eyes over here, it's going to come over to my side, and it's going to be perfect. So when I reach that point, I'm just going to have to pull it a little more to be able to bring it to my side and make it straight. That counts for all the masts in the ship. So if you have a mast that has a small angle left or right, you can adjust it by using these dead eyes, and of course in the big mast using the smaller dead eyes also. Now, I'm going to put the first one over here, but I'm not going to tie it yet because I have to do something over here. You will see what we're going to do. So, first of all, we have to place the dead eye and adjust the height. The height usually is about the height of the rail, not the top of the rail, about here. So the dead eye should be around here. First of all, let's put it on. Of course, we're going to put it on with the small triangle looking up. Now, let me focus the camera. So we have the dead eye over here. The triangle is correct. The one is looking up. Let's put some glue. Of course, some painting after the placing of the dead eyes is definitely required to make corrections, because this is black, it's going to be scratched, and you can see the wood. So definitely we're going to need some painting after. Nothing to worry about, that's normal. Now, let's calculate. I'm going to have it around here, so with this much, I will be all right. Let me pour some glue here, so the rope stays together. Now, I have to do some calculation over to the top. That's a bit hard to film. I'm going to show you later. I have to calculate here the rope, where it starts and where it I need to find the point that the rope starts here and on the other side ends exactly the same type. Let me do that, and I'll get back to you to show you what we're going to do. Alright, now here I have to thank again my friend Dick for this vise, and my friend Simon for this, how to say, clippers? Don't know the exact word for that. Okay, this is a 0.4. We will begin with a small knot. Now that's the hard part. Know how much I'm going to use. Let's cut it and we will see. You see here, I have passed it around the mast and also made a small knot over here to keep it in position. This wasn't easy, so as you can see, I have used some glue to secure it and not having it moving around. Now, let's proceed. Now, let's put the first one. This is 0.45. Now usually the length is up to the platform, so let me cut it. Just a small drop here. To prevent the rope from opening and splitting. Now, with this ingenious tool, we're going to work. Now, let's stretch it. Over here, I believe it's pretty good. Let's place the second. Approximately at the same height, because when we twist it, it will go a little bit higher, but then we can stretch it and go down. Let me twist because my hand is in front of the camera, so you won't be able to see a thing. Let me change the camera view. I believe now it's better. A very boring procedure, but I know that the result is going to be unbelievably beautiful. Again, up to the platform. Just a drop. Done. To the dice position. Now I have to do the other side, and when I do the other side, I'll come back over to this side, and this will go on until every little dead die, every big dead die, sorry, because we have some small ones over here, in the lower level, front, main, and rear mast are complete. This is a very boring. This is a very boring procedure, but it's going to look beautiful. Boring, but the outcome is going to be magnificent. Give me a moment. Now I'm going to make the other side too, so I can show you how it's forming up here, and we'll finish this video. So give me some time. One tip for approximately 6 centimeters of length, you need 60 centimeters of rope. That's approximately 10 centimeters for 1 centimeter over here. I got 4 over here and 2 on the other side, and here how it looks. Of course, this will pile up as we place more and more. So, a difficult procedure. Also boring, and the most boring thing is when I start tying vertical lines over the rope ladders. Oh, that will kill me. I believe this procedure will take over a month. I have to do 3, 6, and 3 above 9. On the other side also 18 rope ladders. Oh boy, it's going to look magnificent after I finish, but until then, this is the most boring thing for me. Beautiful outcome, but boring. So guys, I will meet up with you when I start tying these vertical lines. Don't know if I have finished every other line, every other rope ladders. I will see. Until then, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget the Super Thanks ability, it really helps. And also take your time to check out the Modular Center recommendations that I have made for you. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Take care.